last week. Single leg X, so we're doing over half guard tonight again. Taught these two half guard passes before, some of you know them, but they're ones you need to have in your game and they're super high percentage. We'll just start from close guard, so it doesn't really matter how I get there. So if I help the lapels, search for the sleeves, maybe on the side and snap out, grip. Then from here, I'm pushing out the leg open, and I replace my hand with my knee as I drive my shin across. This leg comes out straight, so Kurt can't make the half guard straight. Talking about this pressure passing, so I win the cross face and the underhook, palm up, and I'm driving my shoulder into Kurt's face, putting a lot of pressure on him. Kurt tries to close the half guard, it's difficult, and then I can weave this leg inside. Engage my hips, move them out. That before. Sometimes I make a mistake and I'm not specific with my grip. So when I stand up, pushing down on this, and my shin or my knee replaces my hand. When I win this cross face, I want to keep this foot well shaped here. But let's just say I don't. Carl drags his legs through and now I'm caught on half guard. So from here, I still have the underhook. I'm going to change my head position on the side of the underhook to the opposite side. Control the elbow again. From Carr's perspective, being on the half guard, he wants his hips under mine and he wants to be on the side. So I'm going to make my grip and I'm going to put all my weight on his arm and I'm going to move my hips off his. So I'm pinning his arm with my upper body. Pinning his knee to the mat, my right leg. Even here.
And just walk out. So all that weight is on his leg. Then I create the space, so I bring his elbow up, and I fill that with my knee, and I put the sole of my foot on his thigh. Before I hit the knee slice, I'm going to turn my foot so that my foot can fit between his calves. So I drive my knee through, left leg kicks my back.
Stand up without controlling this or it can take me over. So I have this, and step up. It doesn't matter how I actually get there. So I push and I fill that space with my knee as this leg comes straight out and I'm looking to win the cross face underhook. But if I'm not specific and car drives through and I'm caught in the half guard, I still have this underhook. So move my head to the far side,
control the elbow, and bring my hips onto the mat, not over this.
Okay? If Kurt points his knees, the way Kurt's pointing his knees towards me, he walks his hips back, gets his knees pointing up in the air, his hips is over mine, and now I'm controlling it. So I need to make sure that if he walks his knees up, I'm coming back. And all my weight, pinning this arm to the mat, pinning this leg to the mat.
So, create space, and bring the elbow up, and bring the left knee into the space, sole the foot on his thigh, and then I'm going to turn my foot so I have a small edge coming through between his calves. Move the top foot, legs to kick through.
So I already have the underhook, I just move my head.
Over the mat, pinning his arm on his knee. Take the space, throw the foot, turn my foot, knee slice, top leg.
And then make a side turn. So let's do it, guys.